Every organism has an ability to resist the diseases. This disease resistance power is known as immunity. So, based on nature of response, immunity is divided into two types. In that, the first one is innate immunity and the second one is acquired immunity. The simple thing is the immunity which we get by birth, so inborn immunity, is known as innate immunity. This inborn resistance to diseases, inborn resistance to the diseases possessed by an organism known as innate immunity. And the second one is acquired immunity. The immunity developed in the organism during its lifetime. The immunity developed against the response of pathogen. That means the organism which gets after birth is known as acquired immunity. Now, let us discuss the types of immunity and how it is classified and what it is. The first one, innate immunity. Just now I told you the immunity which we get by birth. So there is no specific defense before we get. So physical structure, our physiological mechanism possess natural disease resistance power. Let us discuss which innate immunity includes. The first one is a physical barriers. So barrier is a wall. Physical barrier, like skin, is called as physical barrier. So which is the first defense of mechanism in immunity. So all the pathogens are prevented to enter inside the body by the physical barrier skin. So skin is called as innate immunity. Skin, which is a physical barrier, comes under innate immunity. And the second one, physiological barriers. So our body shows some secretions. Our body organs secrete some secretions to get rid some pathogens. See, skin is a first level of defense which prevent entering the bacteria or virus or pathogen. But we have some entrances like mouth, so there is a chance of entering microorganism through the mouth, but there is no problem to us. Why? Because we have a secretion in oral cavity, that is saliva. Saliva contains antibacterial solution. It is like it acts as antibacterial solution. It has an enzyme called lysozyme, which breaks pathogens. So all the secretions comes under physiological barriers. So some secretions I'll reveal you here. Saliva, which produces in oral cavity. Okay, even the pathogen does not killed by the saliva and its enzymes. So the bacteria enters into stomach. The stomach has powerful secretion, HCl. So hydrochloric acid, it is also a physiological barrier. If it enters through the nostrils, there is a mucus lining. Mucus does not allow the pathogen to get inside. If bacteria or virus or pathogen try to get inside through the ear, there is a cerumen. So cerumen won't allow the pathogen to get inside. Even the microbes trying to get inside through the eyes. So we have tear glands, lacrimal glands. They produce the tears. The tears are the antibacterial. Even what we call sebum. So skin possess sebaceous glands. So sebum also acted as antibacterial secretion. So these all secretion comes under physiological barriers. I want to tell you, this is a very common in all the organisms. This may vary in the organisms because these are acquired, these are by birth. All the organisms possess innate immunity as common. Like skin, everybody will have. Secretions are common in every organism. So, and the third one, cellular barriers. In immunological responses, cells play vital role like B cells, T cells, natural killer cells. These are the cells common in everyone. So we get by this immunity by birth, so that it comes under innate immunity, cellular barriers, B cells, T cells, lymphocytes like monocytes, phagocytes, axillary cells. These are all comes under cellular barriers. And the cytokine barriers. Cytokines, the soluble mediators, are play vital role in our immunity. In that, we have interferons. So interferon is a cytokine. So which play vital role in immunity. In what way? A viral infected cell is able to produce a protein, antiviral protein called interferon. So I repeat you, a viral infected cell is able to produce antiviral protein called as interferon. This interferon acts as a coat upon non-infected neighboring cell. So if it is infected cell, right, this infected cell is able to produce interferon. Interferon is a protein, so which acted as a coat upon another cell, so that furtherly it won't get infection. So this is also one of the innate immunity. So physical barriers, physiological barriers, secretions, cellular barriers, cytokines, which comes under innate immunity. Now important concept in immunity is acquired immunity. The immunity developed in the organism during its lifetime, so called as acquired immunity. So it is again two types. If that immunity developed by an organism, if it continues for longer time, the immunity power lasts for longer time or even lifetime, entire lifetime, is called as active immunity. So once the disease resistant power the organism gets, so the power continues for lifetime. So active, every time it is in active mode, so that active acquired immunity. Sometime we get immunity for some time only, like the pathogen will be get rid of and the disease will be healed, but the second time again we have to develop the second immunological response. That is called as passive acquired immunity. Let us see, active acquired immunity is divided into two types, natural and artificial. Just now I told you this is developed by an organism after birth. If that development of immunity by natural infections, by natural infection we get active immunity, then it's said to be natural active. So natural infections, what? For example, I want to tell you about smallpox, chickenpox. These are the diseases we may get in our lifetime only once. What does it mean? If we get the disease, so we develop immunity, that immunity lasts for many days, so lifetime. So that means after some days, if the same pathogen enters inside, so our body is very efficiently, our body get rid of that pathogen. So this is called as active, natural, active acquired immunity. That is the reason smallpox, the eradicated disease from India, okay, and chickenpox. So chickenpox is a common disease, can be seen in India, so in infants. So once the chickenpox affected by a child, he or she never get in the future, because it is natural active acquired immunity. Then coming to artificial is what? This is by the natural infection, right? For example, if we have given infection by giving attenuated microbes, so vaccination comes under artificial active acquired immunity. In vaccination, what they can do, the thing is they inject the pathogen, attenuated pathogen or disabled pathogen into the body. So example, polio vaccine. In polio vaccine, like DPT vaccine, in that they provoke our body to produce antibodies. So that antibodies are, first thing is the antibodies produced by B lymphocytes. So B lymphocytes are differentiated into two types during immunological response. One is plasma cell and effector cell and memory cell. Plasma cell is effector cell. Effector cell and memory cells. The effector cells produce antibodies, and memory cell is ready to produce antibodies whenever secondary infection occurs. So the thing is, so vaccination is nothing but artificially, this is naturally our body is producing antibodies, but here this vaccine is provoking the body to produce antibodies to get rid of many number of diseases. So vaccination comes under artificial active acquired immunity. That is the reason. So polio drops will be administered to the infant children. So that means what, the child is able to produce antibodies. That antibodies last for many days, so they are ready to get rid the polio virus for longer, after many times if it enters into body. So this is vaccination comes under artificial active acquired immunity. Then passive, just now I told you that is developed by an organism for some time. So in that first one, natural passive. So preformed antibodies like, for example, colostrum, so mother milk, so breastfeeding babies, what they suck the milk from the mother, the colostrum contains natural antibodies, so that antibodies enters into the child's body. So this preformed antibodies get rid number of diseases, so that the child cannot get diseases during feeding time. So that is called as natural passive acquired immunity. Do remember, once the baby stopped taking milk from the mother, so that the preformed antibodies cannot enter. So he started drinking milk of other, like cow milk. He started taking the cow milk. So the cow milk doesn't contain natural antibodies. So preformed antibodies won't be. So that he lose that one. So to protect a child, an infant from the diseases, he need to take a mother's milk which contains preformed antibodies. And then one, artificial passive acquired immunity. Artificial what here? So direct giving the preformed antibodies, artificially injecting the antibodies into the body, known as artificial pass. Here what, the colostrum contains the immunoglobulin A, antibody A type will be. This IgA is not prepared by us. IgA is naturally present in the colostrum. So that natural passive acquired immunity. Whereas artificially what, for example, a person got a disease, a pathogen, antigen, so that he is able to produce antibodies, right? So these antibodies is used to treat another person. These antibodies are used to treat another person of same infection. So preformed antibodies are injected, for example, rabies, anti-rabies. So anti-rabies or the preformed, the injection of anti-rabies is what? Preformed antibodies will be. Tetanus, TT injection we take, that is preformed antibody. So preformed antibodies are administered or injected into the body is known as artificial passive. Here what happens here, for example, a person got rabies, so preformed antibodies are injected, finished. Next, after some months, if he again dog has bitten, so he has to go for again preformed antibody. So the difference between artificial active, artificial passive is here, the vaccine provoking to produce natural antibodies in the body. Here what, direct we are administering the antibodies, we are injecting the antibodies. Here we are not injecting antibodies, we are provoking to make antibodies in the body. So this is the difference between artificial active and artificial passive. So this is types of immunity.